Alright, so today I'm going to show you guys how to repaint your windshield wiper arms. I went ahead and taken mine off and folded the base of it down flat because I don't want to paint underneath this. I really don't care because it's going to be folded down the entire time anyways. First off, you're going to want to remove your wiper blades depending on how they are. These will slide off like this. And also, I don't know if it matters or not, but I went ahead and marked mine. This is the driver's side, and this is the passenger side. Next, see, I don't know if you can see it right here or not, but it's kind of getting nasty looking up here as well. And some of them might be worse than others, but what we're going to do is kind of scuff this up to where it's a little bit more flat, depending on how much paint you have peeling up or sticking up or rust or anything. We're going to try to sand that down a little bit. We're going to do that now. I'm going to start out with 220. If that doesn't seem to be doing the job, I'll drop it down a little bit. And then go back over it with probably 400 just to make it smooth again. It might not really matter because I'm going to end up priming it anyways. So, anyways, here we go. Just to be safe, I'm going to go back over it with 400. That way no lines or grains show up through the paint or primer. I like to make sure I want to clean that all off and everything, and I'm going to use some paint thinner just to wipe it down, make sure it's clean. So now we're going to prime and paint. I'm going to go ahead and sand the other one down. And get ready for that. Now, I don't know if you can see that or not, but I've kind of made a hanger, turned a hanger into two hooks and kind of hanging them down from outside to get better all the way around instead of having to paint and flip and everything else on the ground. I just want to do light coats first. Don't put heavy coats on there. Two more coats of that, and then we'll switch to paint. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's the dried primer, 20-30 minutes. Now I'm going to put some Krylon satin black. I didn't want gloss, I didn't want flat, so kind of went in between. Same thing, just do light coats. Might do about the same, maybe three or four coats. Depending on how it turns out, I might clear it, I might not. Just depends. I'll sit there and let that dry. And like I said, I'm going to do about two or three more coats on top of that. And we'll see what we end up with. Like I said, might clear it, might not. It just depends. Alright, so there's the finished product. It's, like I said, it's satin, so. I think I'm going to go ahead and clear them just to help protect them a little bit more. So, go ahead and do that. Now I'm just using Krylon clear, it's a flat clear, so it won't be glossy still. But it will protect it. That's it. I'll show you either a picture or a video of the finished product.